K News. Here they are, the Valley's favorite talkers, Bill Feingold and Kevin Holmes.
7:37.
Show off.
I know. Yeah. See, because I'm getting better. I'm getting better every day.
Yes, you are.
A friend from years back, from the way back at the Burton Plaza, Frankie Verroca. How are you?
Hello, Billy. Good morning.
Yeah, see, Billy, they know me. Good morning. Frankie Verroca is a star of stage, screen, and cruise ships. What, how do I introduce you?
Well, now I'm going to be on the Rachael Ray TV show tomorrow.
I know. We're giving our audience a sneak preview, right?
Yes, apparently somebody, my phone is getting crazy. I just got a call from a friend who said they're already promoing it today. So
right.
It's kind of exciting.
And Rachael Ray is on after our show, so people are allowed to watch Rachael Ray. Now, Frankie, how did this occur? Why are you on the Rachael Ray show tomorrow?
What's going on?
You know what? It is so crazy out there. Well, you know, when I got off the cruise ships, you know, I was on the Love Boat with your friend Gavin and
right.
all them for years.
Yep.
Well, when I got back to New York to be a character actor, I looked around and I went, oh, my gosh, I'm old now. What am I going to do?
Right.
And I saw, like, street people, like crazy people. And I started letting my hair grow longer and letting my beard grow longer because I was so clean cut on the ship.
Yes.
Well, it turns out the last time you saw me, Billy, which is over 5 years ago, that was my last haircut.
What?
Whoa!
Well, see, he's dating me. I'm dated by Frankie's last haircut. Yeah, we met here in Palm Springs.
Yeah.
Right. I have that picture of you and I visiting together.
Yes.
Well, anyway, my hair is down to my belly button.
Yeah. Fabulous.
Oh, my God.
Now, let's tell you, you've already had the makeover, right?
Well, I guess I can tell you that, right?
Yeah. In show business, we'd say your makeover is in the can. Right?
That's right. Well, it's going to be out of the can tomorrow, that's for sure. So the long hair down to my belly button and my scraggly beard. So I've gone from looking, well, my one friend said I'm going from homeless to handsome. I wouldn't actually
You're very handsome. So if I watch Rachael Ray tomorrow, I will see this happening?
Oh, yes, you will, in a very big way. And basically, I was playing the street characters. And by the way, do I have to smell like bacon or something? What were you talking about?
Crinkle cut fries.
That was Amy Armstrong. We like our women to smell like bacon, you know.
Well, the way I looked, believe me, people kept their distance, whether I smelled or not.
Wow.
But anyway, I was very lucky to be on the last several years. I've been on about almost 100 movies and TV shows playing either homeless people or cult members or old hippies or junkies.
Oh, good.
Hey, if it works for you.
I've been doing that. I was on Saturday Night Live about 6 months ago as a cult member on that, carrying a news machine gun. Yeah, but anyway, but those days are gone. Starting tomorrow, you will see I think I'll call myself the Love Boat Frankie again, and I'll make hundreds of thousands of cruise ship passengers happy that
you going to go back to work on the cruise ships?
No. I'm busy here in New York.
Okay.
I'm really fortunate to be a character actor here in the city, so why not? You know?
Let's tell people. I know Frankie because when I was running the Burton Plaza, next door, a late great Roz lived there. Roz lived there, but her niece or her cousin?
I forget, actually.
The comedian, but she's no longer with us.
Roz. Oh, yes,
Roz.
Of course.
Joy.
You mean Joycey.
Joycey, yeah.
What?
Joycey, the one who used to say, darling, Joycey would say, darling, I love you, you're so handsome, I would do a backflip into the cosmos.
Yes, yeah, okay. Yeah. I'm so glad to hear about your success. Do you ever come out here?
I will be coming out. Now that I don't have all this long hair to deal with,
I can
travel better. But yes, I am going to try to get out there maybe in a few months' time, and we'll get together and we'll chit-chat.
Okay. Did you have any sort of, like, reaction when they cut off all of your hair?
Oh, yeah, did they keep it, like, a secret to you, and then you had to look in the mirror all of a sudden?
Yes. Oh, my God. They covered the mirrors in the dressing room. You cannot see yourself. They were so serious. Do not look. As they were guiding me down to the stage, don't look. There's a mirror. Oh, my God. And you know my stylist, my fashion stylist.
Right.
Do you know him, Tommy DiDario?
Oh, sounds Tommy, familiar. Is he one?
Yes, Tommy DiDodario, GQ. Look him up right
okay.
now.
Right.
He's the fashion stylist. And then my hairstylist was from the Oscar Blondie Salon,
oh,
where,
how-
you know, all the stars, Kelly Ripa gets her hair done. The Trumps get their hair done there. Not
you,
Donald,
oh.
I think the women.
Did you get highlights and lowlights? Is your hair, what color is your hair right now?
No, they didn't do anything to the color. I'm actually, Billy, kind of a silver fox these days now.
Wow. So is Bill Feingold.
Yeah, Frankie Verroca.
just my hair, not my face. My face is done what it is.
It's younger than springtime. Well, Frankie, how did you get in touch with Rachael Ray? How did this come about?
Okay, this is so fluky. You're going to love this. My 100-year-old Sitsy Francie. Sitsy is slang for Aunt Francie.
Okay.
Well, Sitsy Francie had her 100th birthday last September, and I went to Hershey, Pennsylvania, and there were 150 people. We had a wonderful party for her. She's 100, and she said, "Why did you do this? Why are you doing this?" And I said, "Well, we want to have a celebration of your life while you're alive."
Right.
So that was a lot of fun. And she yelled at me, "What's wrong with you? Look at you, your hair. You look like,
Charles
look like
Manson."
She said I look like Dynasty Duck. I think she got it backwards.
Yeah. Oh, Duck Dynasty, guys?
Dynasty Duck, whatever.
Yeah.
And so between
Dynasty
her,
Duck.
So I did a little video of her yelling at me with my cousins laughing in the background. And she is a big fan of Rachael Ray's. And so she doesn't know this yet, I don't think she's listening.
Right.
But Rachael Ray's going to say her name on TV tomorrow.
She'll
and
be
they're going to actually
ecstatic.
Show a little bit of that footage that I did. So she is going to... We're not
Plots.
Telling her. It's a secret.
She's going to She might not make it to 101 if she didn't keep it a secret.
I know, but I thought that too. It could be the moment. But anyway, let's keep our fingers crossed about that. But anyway,
man.
I just sort of, it just fluke. Billy, you know show business. Fluke,
yes,
timing, luck, whatever. Yep.
Good
you know?
For you, Frankie. Well, we miss you. And when you come to the West Coast, we'll get your good friend Jeff Tractor, who's working like crazy.
Yeah, he is working like crazy.
I know Jeff is always working. I don't even know. I left a message for him. I don't know if he's on land right now or where he is. But
he's
I'm
usually
sure
at
call.
Ralph's. You can find him at Ralph's a lot.
well, that's good to know.
Yeah.
Anyway, say hi for me.
I will.
But I will be visiting you all soon.
Okay,
I
and I am going to watch you tomorrow on Rachael Ray. So everybody, after our show tomorrow, you're allowed to watch Rachael Ray.
Yes, and anybody can go to my website, my Facebook page. Frankie Verroca Entertainer, although no one can spell my last name. But
I was
going to
say, how
that.
Do you spell that?
Spell it, Frankie.
V as in victory, E-R-R-O-C-A. Frankie Verroca.
Oh, I would have been so far off of that spelling.
I know,
definitely.
Kevin, no one. Newspaper articles, they spell my name wrong. It's a continuous thing. So.
Yeah,
but anyway, go on my Frankie Verroca Entertainer Facebook page, and they can follow all the stuff on there. Or Twitter. They can find me on Twitter, too. So,
Frankie, congratulations. And I will be watching tomorrow. So I bet Rachael Ray fell in love with you.
You know what? She was the sweetest thing. And they all were. Everyone at that show was as kind and as sweet and as lovely as you can imagine. They really were. I'm not just saying that.
And are you going to keep this makeover up?
Well, I'll try. You know.
That sounds like
trying.
A no to me.
Yeah, I know you're okay.
No, don't say that. Don't say that. But the outfit they put me in is really nice. I get to keep the clothes.
Sweet.
Yeah,
so you'll see me looking very suave, at least for those few moments on TV anyway.
All right, Frankie.
You don't want to know how I look right now or how I smell. Never mind that.
No, Frankie, I know it's all good. It's all good. Well, thanks for calling in, Frankie. We'll be watching you on Rachael Ray tomorrow.
Thank you, guys. And I love listening to you here in New York because I feel like I'm back in Palm Springs when I listen to you guys. It's
awesome.
Wonderful.
That's right. Thanks, Frankie. Continued success.
I love you. Bye.
Have a good day, Frankie.
That's right. He's going to be on Rachael Ray tomorrow.
He's a lot of fun.
Oh, hysterical.
He is
and
very, very funny.
Very talented. I mean, really
I'm sure.
talented. So,
I mean, he's been in a ton of stuff.
7:54, Bulldog and Kevin. I just showed Kevin. I found Frankie Verroca, who was just on the show, on Facebook. And
wow,
that's 5 years worth of hair.
That's a long, long hairdo he had.
Yeah. I tell you, he's very talented, very funny.
He's very funny.
He used to, on the cruise ships, he was like Julie.
Oh.
Like, you know.
Yeah, like the cruise.
Entertainment. You
yeah,
know,
the director.
This is yeah, making fun, having people make have fun and everything. And
nice.
He did it for years. Years and years and years. He said, who knew?
Right.
You know. Okay.
Hmm.